I wrote the script for this video at the end of last school year, but I never got around to posting it. And I felt like I'd share it now that music has become an even more integral part of my life. So here it is. Perhaps it was the washed-out browned color which seemed to be splashed over the title, Cowboy Songs, written in all caps, circled by a cartoon lasso, which initially attracted my attention. Very clearly, the book was old. I had stumbled across it in a bin of music books at a garage sale this last weekend. Upon closer inspection, an old price was written in the upper right-hand corner of 10 cents. Ironically, I paid 15 times that for the book. The sheer fact that a simple paperback volume had survived so long, in remarkably good shape, was reason enough for me to take it home, even before really investigating the songs inside. To my delight, there were guitar chords above the lyrics, as well as bass and treble clefs. I usually play my music by ear, so I went searching for recordings of the songs within. I was successful in finding two songs which I instantly fell in love with: the crackle of the shellac 78 RPM record, and a voice that sounded as alive as an old recording could greeted me. The first song was Little Old Sod Shanty on My Claim, and here I was introduced to the style and feeling of the music this book aimed to capture. The lyrical content had historical value, but maintained sad and somber undertones, which helped me better imagine the life of those living in the so-called American Wild West. Remember that in 1935, the year of the book's publication, World War II had yet to begin, and the genre we would now call country music was in its fledgling infancy at best. These were folk songs built to keep the history of a people alive. In my own opinion, they succeeded, and the particular collection of songs, a self-proclaimed treasury, manages to encapsulate the feelings of loneliness and a great wide open land which covers so much of America. While attempting to learn these songs, I realized just how slowly and poorly I managed to read sheet music. I described it to my girlfriend as a child, first encountering a computer keyboard, and painfully plunking out each key with a single finger. Guitar tab is no great hurdle, but distinguishing notes on a musical staff is quite a challenge. This video seemed a fitting place as any to just discuss what sheet music appears to be to me. I occasionally cover songs with my girlfriend. She was a classically trained musician who can read music and is unfamiliar with tablature or even chord fingerings. I wanted to cover an obscure slowcore song by the name of Try to Sleep. The intro and main melody were not on the internet already transcribed, so I took to learning it by ear. Once I had successfully memorized the melody, I realized I needed to communicate it to her. What you are seeing on screen now was my attempt to do this. It may look rudimentary and confusing to those of you who are familiar with standard musical notation, but allow me to explain how it communicates all of the necessary elements one may need to recreate the melody. Firstly, I avoided a clef sign. This was because my audience was my girlfriend, and she plays violin and mandolin, making this unnecessary. Next, I noticed that I needed to mark the lowest line, which is the E note. I did this by simply labeling this line on notebook paper. She later informed me that the line dividing the bars of music is usually what identifies the lowest note, but I had no knowledge of this and did what I felt was intuitive. Finally, I placed the notes on their corresponding lines relative to the location of the E note, and a dividing line where the chords would change on the guitar. With only minimal knowledge of sheet music, I had created a set of instructions which communicate to another musician what they should be playing. Of course, this may look unprofessional, and as I was later informed, was difficult to follow, but the creation of it was a wonderful exercise for my own brain. It helped me understand how I process music, as well as what other musicians need to understand it. In a sense, it was an exchange of language. This may not be unlike someone who is a non-native English speaker attempting to read Shakespeare, grasping only the general idea but getting lost in each little detail. I had a big picture and an idea to communicate. I did my best with my limited tools available. Moving forward, I understand the importance of organization and why things are placed just so, but as I said, my brain sometimes has a lot of ideas which I need to record as fast as possible. At times, it is difficult for me to gauge if a reader or listener is following along because everything is logical, reasoned, and sensible from my point of view. Stopping for a second to examine what I had just created was a helpful exercise. To bring things back around to my newly discovered treasury of songs, I plan to carefully work through each one. I attempt to grasp the musical notation as well as the historical importance of the tunes. I am fascinated by the ever-changing world of music and pop culture in general. Many of these songs have probably never been played by younger people or even any living person today. Music contains a history, and it is very important to keep that history alive. If you will allow me, I would love to go off on a tangent about just how I realized that music was the living demonstration of history. Last Wednesday, I went to my final old-time jam before I head back home for the summer from my college town. At the beginning of this school year, I was out on a walk, and I happened upon two older gentlemen playing music. I stopped and listened, and was invited to their jam session the following night. Every Wednesday from there on, with a short break through the coldest parts of winter, I attended these jam sessions. Sometimes as many as 8 people would show up, and they would spend 2 hours playing songs from the turn of the century or older. The music was historically the music of dances, and was a wonderful way to set the mood and make friends. I was the only young adult at these jam sessions, but I grasped early on that this was unimportant. When I sat down to play, I felt transported back in time. I could imagine myself playing rhythm guitar, albeit poorly, at a country dance long before recorded music was a thought in anyone's head. The participants of the jam encouraged me to hone my musical skills and use my ear to determine the key and the chords which accompanied the ever-present fiddle. Of course, this was a challenge, and at times it was frustrating, but I would not trade those moments for anything. This desire to perpetuate history through song is exactly what I hope to do with the acquisition of cowboy songs. If I spend the time to learn each tune and play it right, I could brighten the day of those around me who are graced with the opportunity to relive history through those who studied it. Unconventional as it may be, music is certainly a mode of communication, and the necessary elements for that communication may change from setting to setting, but as long as you are playing and having fun, you're doing it correctly.